So I started with sanding the top with the 80 grit, and I'm using the festool sander. The 80 grit breaks the stain down. Then comes the 220 grit, and that is basically for, you know, smoothing out the finish and taking away any residue that is left. And finally, I use the 320 grit, which makes the surface very smooth and clean and ready to be stained. So you see the watermark there. I just, you know, sanded a little harder, and the 220 grit just took that away, and it was ready to be stained. Now step two is filling in any missing veneer or any dents that you may have on the piece. And for this, I'm using the wood filler. Most of the time you will see me using the 3M wood filler. It is a bit thick, so what I do is I mix water in it and make it a little softer, which helps in the easy application and also dries faster. So I left it for 2 to 4 hours to dry. Once the wood filler was dry, I took a sanding block and sanded it down so that it was even and nice. I also sanded down this whole piece. This is an old stained empire chest, and the stain was loose, so it was easy to sand it down. Like I said, this piece is not primed and just painted, so that is what I'm trying to show you in this video. So after sanding it down, I took a baby wipe and wiped off the piece nicely. I mostly use water and paper towel or baby wipes because I like to keep my furniture chemical free. So I wiped it out nicely, and all the dust was collected on this wipe. You can just see, and it doesn't fly around your work area. So once the surface was completely dry, I took Wise Owl gray linen and painted the surface. So if you notice, I haven't used any water. My brush was damp, and I applied thick coats of gray linen. So I applied 2 coats of gray linen on this piece. So when you're looking for a finish like this, you have to look for a color that is more neutral, more earthy looking, and then you use the second part that I'm going to show you to get this kind of a look. So you can order Wiseout Paints from the link that is posted in the comments, or you can look for a similar tone in other brands. So I just took the paint on the brush and applied on the surface, horizontal on the front and vertical on the sides, because that's going to play a main role when I apply the wax. Now comes the second part, that is waxing. So you have heard always that you have to seal the paint with a clear wax or a clear coat before you apply the antique waxes. Now I wanted to give a very restoration hardware kind of a look to this piece, so I avoided the part where I had to seal the paint, because once you seal the paint, it acts as a barrier for the chalk paint to soak up the waxes, and I wouldn't have got the look. So I went on with the Wise Owl dark walnut wax straight onto the chalk painted furniture. So I painted 2 thick coat of the gray linen. I sanded it lightly so that it was smooth, and then I applied the walnut wax. Now wiping, you have to make sure that you're wiping off the wax in the direction of the paint so that it comes off smoothly and it leaves those clear lines and looks like it is blended. Now comes the front part. So you see, I'm applying the wax in circular motion. You can apply it in any way you like, horizontal, vertical, or circular, but wiping it off is the main part. So I tend to apply circular because it is less hurting on my arms, and secondly, I want the wax to grip onto the paint in entirety. So once my wax was there on the drawer, I took the rag on the clean side. You can just keep on folding the rag, and then I started clean taking off the wax. You can see now in the horizontal direction, and that was the direction I painted it to. So once you take it in this direction, what you're doing is you are blending the wax so that there are no patches left on the surface, and you get a clean, nice looking surface. Now comes the staining. I'm using Dixie Belle No Paint Gel Stain. I like gel stains easier to work with. You can apply it with the applicator pad or lint-free rag or a paper towel like I'm using. It's more easier. So I just take a tiny bit of the gel stain and I rub it on the surface. It's easier and just goes on fine. And once I have covered the entire wood, what I do is I take another a sheet of the paper towel and just take off the excess, and whatever the excess is, you can see it comes on to the paper towel, and then you let it to dry before you seal it. Now restoring. So these are the inside of the drawers, and you can see they had patches all over. So I wanted to restore it and give them a nice wood color look. So I used the Wiseowl Salve in the lemon scent, and I applied it generously on the inside of the drawers and restored them back to their original color. And you can see how beautiful they looked on the inside. And I also sealed this entire piece in Wiseowl Salve once the waxes were dried. And here is the final finished look. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.